It's beautiful. I mean, I'm not saying I'm beautiful. No, I think it's beautiful.
You are beautiful, right? Whether you had makeup on or not, right? You have so much to offer this world. You're doing so many things. And I think that's what's hard for women to accept. Yeah. Hey, ladies, welcome back to my Fierce Aging series. Today, I have a really beautiful episode. Lots of things that are takeaways for you today. So I have Linda in from Connecticut. She's going to be 72 in a couple days. And we do a really beautiful makeup tutorial, but I wanted to show you how you could take it from day to night. So I'm going to show you that transition in this video. And you know, something unexpected happened in the video where I made the call out to Linda, and it was very interesting. And it's such a takeaway. It's really what my channel's all about, how I always want you to leave when you are either here on set or you've just watched one of my videos. It's a really important message for you today. And Linda was really, she knew it and we discussed it. And then I hopefully that you can take some of these tidbits and apply them to your life. So are you ready? Let's get this beauty started. So when did you retire?
I guess officially last spring. This semester I'm not teaching an adjunct course.
Do you feel kind of lost?
I had read a book called Don't Retire, Rewire.
I saw that.
Yeah. I just knew my whole life that I was working toward being able to be retired and get involved in the arts. So I've done a couple of things in that area. I'm pretty busy, actually. But occasionally I'll say, wow, I'm retired already. So
what was like your biggest takeaway from the book?
It was not to think you're going to sit around and, you know, eat bonbons.
Right.
You know, keep busy. But I have enough time at home now to enjoy my home. And when I do things, I don't have to rush through it. I never have to drive in snow anymore. So that's
wow.
Good.
Yeah.
And then I just keep busy. So I do. And I love what I'm doing. It's not like I'm just keeping busy.
Right, right.
Yeah.
So that's interesting, though, because I guess maybe some people do think that, you know, retirement, like, what are you going to do? I think that it's like your second life, right? You've done something for 30 years, yeah. 40 yeah. years, maybe.
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden retiring, you know, maybe a lot of women don't really know what that picture is.
That could be. And I mean, my advice would be, well, before you retire, get some plans in motion for things you're going to do,
right.
Whether it's volunteering or, you know, meeting once a week for lunch with this friend. I happen to live an hour and 38 minutes from New York City, so okay. I can pop into museums, and then I do the volunteer work. I actually go on the train to the botanical.
So how many hours do you volunteer a month?
Well, most people only have to do I think it's 4 tours a month, but because I live a distance away, they let me come down one day.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
So that's good.
So what have you done to your skin? I mean, what were your real battles? Has it been your whole life or?
I have had a dermatologist since I was a teen, but at probably about 30, things settled down and that was good. And I mentioned to you earlier, I had had laser surgery probably about 30 years ago. And that was very helpful.
Uh-huh.
And so I'm always not only thinking about what I put on my face, but always thinking about from the inside, what should I not be eating?
Uh-huh.
No preservatives, less sugar.
I do
like dessert. And so I'm always working on that. Keep kind of a list of good ideas. I love all of your ideas. I'm not trying to flatter you. Just doing this was kind of a big step.
Coming here is a big step, but you've also been dabbling in, I don't know, would you say acting or being a part of these shows on HBO?
Yeah. Well, I think I can name it. I know I can't show pictures, but I gave tours in Newport, Rhode Island at the Mansions for 3 summers. And so I just love that whole history, the Vanderbilt history and everything. And then when HBO's The Gilded Age was going to be on HBO Max, I said, oh, I would love to wear a bustle and the whole outfit. So it took me 2 years. I found out who the casting agents were. And when I first applied, they said, oh, we've wrapped for the season. But then I applied again and I was on another one, The Marvelous Mrs. Maisel. Just background. I'm not trying to be an actress. And so that has been fun. And then in the meantime, I've done some traveling. So I cannot complain.
So what would be your advice to some of the ladies in my audience that might be thinking, oh, Linda's really bringing a different perspective to retiring. What advice would you help them or say to them to get them moving and pushing them to do what they want to do, but they're afraid to do?
Yeah, I love that question. I would say identify what your secure spot is in your life so you can have that. But then just go for it. I thought for sure I would have to have an agent and professional pictures. The casting company, which is a well-known one, just said send a full-length picture and a picture of your face. And I did, and that's within a month I was doing this extra work. Having different things in different areas of interest, if something doesn't work out, you've got that other thing. Mm-hmm. If the extra work didn't work out, I had a trip planned to France. So I could look forward to that. I know everyone can't go to France, but I saved for a long time.
Right. And you're constantly working and you're doing different things that do, you know, offer you being able to take a trip to France. Yeah. Or now you did go to France last year, you said.
Yes, I went in October and I went again this May.
You were loving France, I see.
Before that, I went to Madrid last year.
Give me three words that would describe yourself to my audience.
Well, you use the word fresh, and I mean fresh in the sense of start fresh every day, that type of thing. Curious. Mm-hmm. Maybe something like humorous, light, like I see the light side of things. I don't like to see darkness and drama.
That's great. Yeah. So we are going to move into our makeup tutorial now. Okay. And create a beautiful look. We are going to start off prepping Linda's skin. I want something really light and just very milky. And this is the Powder Soft Milky Lotion from Estee Lauder. And then I'm going to just hydrate her under eye so everything's prepped with the Estee Lauder Ultimate Diamond. This is the Transformative Eye Serum. It's really beautiful. It's light, really moisturizes the skin. I didn't put on my silicone eye pads today, but this would be something that I would do right after the serum. So it pushes it all into the skin and you'll see your eyes really, really hydrated. It really does make a big deal. So if you have time in the morning to do that or at night, that is a perfect product to use. They're called These Bags or Designer, because of course we need to be positive about our bags that we have when we're aging. It's just a part of it and we have to, we don't have to enjoy it, but we have to honor it, right? So we just work with it. I'm going to prep Linda's lips with a little rose lip balm. This is going to be really nice and hydrating. So when they get to the lips, this is what I like to do first. I like to prep the lips so I'm not doing it right before I do the lip liner. So I really want these to just be nicely moisturized and prepped. I'm going to be using our Fiercely Smooth. This is the face primer. It's really nice. It's like a gel. So it's going to be this really hydrating, it's like a burst of little hydration. And then this is going to really prep your skin so your BB cream goes on very smooth. Maybe you're doing a serum foundation. Maybe you're doing your own foundation tinted moisturizer. So I'm going to just use my flat foundation brush. I'm going to just pick up a little bit of the product. And I like to work on the kind of like the T-zone first and then bring the product out. I don't want too much of the face primer on. You just need just enough to be placed on the skin, worked in, but not overwhelming the skin. So I did about a pump, maybe a pump and a half, and you can see it nicely spreads over the face. I'm going to use our soft gray skinny brow pencil. I just want to shape out Linda's brows first before I go into the eyes. So I want to make sure I see the hair we have here really nice, and then a little bit of the lateral we're missing, which is very common. So I know we're starting where we need to. I can see where we're arching, but we just need to work on this lateral part here. So what I'll do is I'm using the soft gray and I'm going to just give wispy strokes. I don't want to really darken the brow, but I do want to reshape it just to give it a little bit more structure. You'll see that there are a couple little gray hairs that I love to fight with also. And then we can just do a little brow mascara over that. You'll see, I want to match the color of her hair with this lateral part. I don't want it lighter. I'm not using taupe or dark blonde. I want this soft gray. And the best thing about this pencil is that you can go very light to get a light soft gray color, or you can put more pressure that's going to give you a deeper color. So I wanted you to have range. So that is how you use the pencil. So if you just need to have a little bit of that gray color, just marrying the two together so it looks like one brow. If you need a little bit darker, you can press a little bit harder, and then you will get this really beautiful synergy to the brow. To cover the grays, this is something that really is a challenge for me all the time. I see these grays pop out and they're like, I don't really want to highlight my brows. My hair is fine with the gray, but the brows. So I'm going in with our brow mascara. It's Milk Chocolate. So it's going to cover, I'm just wanting to cover these little bit of these gray brows. Not too many, but if I could just get them, they will easily blend together with the soft gray. It's not going to be noticeable that I'm using this Milk Chocolate. I just want to get a little bit of coverage on those grays so it looks like we have more hair than we do, because those gray hairs make it look like there is no hair there. And that's why you don't want to pluck them out, because you need every single hair. So just cover them with the brow mascara. So again, we don't have any makeup on. We have the brows done. We have white hair. We have very fair skin. So it could look like it's a little too dark, but it's not. Again, this is a process. We're building on this. We're going to start with our eye primer. This is my first step that I do. I am working out of my essential brush kit here. This is all you need. These are great vegan brushes. They're super, super soft. And I really, really made that a very big point for me, because I wanted you to not drag brushes across the face or feel like you're creating irritation or it's not enjoyable, not comfortable for you. So I spent a lot of time designing these to be soft. And if you had to work a little harder and you had to smudge that eyeliner, you're not like, oh gosh, this brush is just too rough on my eyes. So that is something that I really like about this. I'm using my angled concealer brush going into the eye primer. And what we're gonna do is we're going to neutralize out this eyelid. So we have pigmentation. That is a normal thing that happens as we age. I go right from the base of the lash all the way up to the brow bone, and I work it out like this. And I come all the way into this inner corner where we have all of that darkness. So you're going to see that you get a really nice neutral eye ready for your eyeshadow. I'm going to use our Fresh Beauty eyeshadow palette. This is a 3-well palette. These are Sheen. I have two little brushes that I designed for you that come into the compact. And I'm going to be using first my flat eyeshadow brush. This is going to lay the product really beautifully. And I'm going to use the middle color. So I'm going to pick up the eyeshadow on the brush, and then I'm going right to the center, and I'm going to apply the product, and then I'm going to bring it down. So this is a really great way to see how much eyeshadow you want to apply. If you feel that you want a little bit more, you can build from the middle, going into that inner corner, coming back out, and then bring it up to right where the eye socket is, this brow bone here. So it's really nice. You're going to see this really light sheen. Now, Linda normally goes for a matte, but I wanted to give her something a little bit different, and it just picks up a little bit of that highlight on the lid. Now, Linda also did say that one of the words she used for herself was fresh. So this is going to give her that beautiful fresh look. And I think this is so beautiful in your 70s to have a little bit of that reflective sheen on the eye. And it's not about glitter, and it's not about having too much going on, because I know a lot of ladies say, oh, but I have wrinkles, oh, it highlights that. I brought the sheen all the way down so you could have just that little highlight. And it just looks really like you have this fresh eyelid skin. I'm going to flip the brush over to the clean side, and I'm going to use the lightest color here, and I'm just going to sweep the brow bone. Going into the darkest color here with my tapered blending brush. It's like a little pencil. It's nice because it comes to a point. I'm going to just roll it into the product. And I'm going to go to the end of the eye right here. And I just want to give some dimension. I'm just adding a little bit of darkness here, going into that crease. Really nice, just sweeping motions here. Now, again, these eyeshadows are talc-free. They're really nice and smooth. I wanted you to get a nice, soft look. Didn't want hard. I didn't want this to be hard for you to blend out or to combine these three colors. Maybe you just want to use one. Maybe you want to use two. It's really up to you. But this is really just a very fresh, natural look. Now, if you want to go back and really blend out, if you feel like it's not really where you want it, I have a blending brush, an eyeshadow blending brush. It's very nice and wispy that you can take back over and just make sure that everything is nice and blended just right here in that crease. I'm going to take all my pads. These are biodegradable. This is oil-free. They do come with ones that are for waterproof makeup or mascara. I'm just using the oil-free. And what I do is I just clean up just on the ends to make sure that if anything fell out, which we really don't have a lot of fallout with my shadows, I can easily clean up. And that's why I do the eyes first. I don't do concealer and my color correctors and my BB cream or foundation, because I want to be able to clean that up and not have any of that darkness going where we really need it to be nice and light. I'm going to do something that I like to do. I don't always do it, but I have our waterproof dark chocolate and I have our waterproof plum liner. So what I like to do is, especially using like Fresh Beauty or Naughty Nancy, and Linda has brown eyes, I'm going to do a combo. I'm going to do the dark chocolate on the top, and then I like to layer the plum on the bottom. So you get it's very subtle, but you know, it's fun to play with color. So let's go with the dark chocolate on the top of the eyeliner. What I do is I go right to the base of the lash. It's very smooth, so you don't need a lot of pressure. So I'm going to come up just a tad. You know, I like to have a little bit of lift at the end of the eye, come across, and I'm just kind of pushing it into the lashes. Before I move on and the waterproof eyeliner sets up, I'm going to take my short smudge brush and I'm just going to drag it across to smooth out the eyeliner. So I have a little bit of time just to kind of smooth it out, give it a little bit of a more of a smudgy look, just where it's really nice and soft. I can just layer over the dark chocolate on the top, which I think I'm going to, since I nicely smudged out this dark chocolate. I'm going to just layer right on top this plum, and I just love that kind of combo. Again, it's very subtle. It's not like you're going to see this right away, but it does add a really nice dimension. It's also being creative with your makeup. Just taking the waterproof plum and I'm going right underneath the eyes. I'm going to take my short smudge brush and just go underneath the eyes also, just to smooth out that line. I'm going to be using our Volume Up mascara. This mascara is a volumizing mascara. It has this beautiful wand that's going to grip all your lashes. Now, Linda has longer lashes and they're beautiful. And so what we're going to do is we're going to go to the base of her lashes. We're going to wiggle back and forth, and you can see it like literally pulls the whole lid up because it's grabbing all of your lashes. So I like to get the base, because what you're doing is you are making that line thicker at the base. I want you to really get at the base of the lash right here. So it's almost touching the wet line, but it's not. And then you lift up, and this is where you want to be a little bit slower. You don't want to go super fast. I'm sure that over the years, we've kind of got into the habit of going really fast. I'm going to take our heated eyelash curler and I'm going to bend the lashes back for Linda. So what I'm going to do is I've heated it up and I'm going to just go to the base and I'm going to mold the lashes now that they have the mascara on. So basically it's like hairspray. Now that we lifted the lashes just a little bit, just to give it a little bit more staying power, I'm going to go into a color corrector, which is our Just Peachy. Now the eyes have been prepped. That's a really important step. We did do the eye serum underneath the eyes. So now your your color corrector will go on nice and smooth. So what this color corrector is doing, it's going to cancel out any of those grays, blues, darkness, and just really give a really fresh look for underneath the eyes. So when you put on your concealer doesn't have to work that hard. So I'm just going right up into that corner, coming down where I see the darkness. Now I'm gonna have the Just Peachy just set up while I go in with our no redness. I do see a little bit of redness in the skin. So what I'll do is I don't cover the whole skin. Where I see most of the redness or the pink, I will just take it on the skin just like this. Usually around the nose, this is where I get it. I have some broken capillaries. And then, so just a little bit more pink, really in like the cheek area here. And then we'll work that in. I'm taking the foundation buffing brush just for the no redness right now. We'll just work in this no redness so the green cancels out the red. So we'll have a nice neutral skin to apply our BB cream to. If you can't get around the nose with the foundation buffing brush, you can use your angled concealer brush because it's angled. It'll get right around the nose and really nicely blend in your color corrector. Now I'm going to take my angled concealer brush and just work the Just Peachy color corrector into the skin. I'm taking my creamy concealer in light, and this has a beautiful wand that holds all of the product at the top. So if you were going and saying you had certain issues, maybe you had a big pigmentation spot, what have you, you can literally directly pinpoint where you want this because it gives you that opportunity to only apply where you want it. It's not like, oh, it's too much. This was a big deal. Because you don't want to have too much concealer. We don't want to cake on everything. We want it to be light. So same thing underneath the eyes. So I can really pinpoint where I want it. Usually we have this area here, and then I can take the wand and just kind of drag it across on the top here and give me just enough of this concealer. So there's a lot of different ways that you can apply this with this beautiful wand. It's a dome. So again, I've showed you before where you can just drag it across the skin if you want to, and you're gonna get a nice application. Taking my angled concealer brush, I'm going to just buff this into the skin. You're gonna see that I have a light touch. I'm not dragging the product. I want this product to really set up and stay where I want it to stay, but not be too aggressive where I'm just quickly trying to just put it on the skin and then go. I want it to be nicely worked in just like this. I didn't put that much on, so we don't have that much working into the skin. I'm going to test out two different colors of the BB cream on Linda's skin. I have the fair and the light, and I want you to see what it looks like on her skin. She has a lot more pink in her skin. She's very fair. And the fair of our BB cream has pink undertones. So we're going to see what that looks like. And then the light is more of a cool neutral. This we're going to first swatch is the fair. So this is a fair on Linda's skin. And then the next color is going to be the light. So you can see this is going to have more of a warm tone against her skin. And the light is going to have more of that pinky undertone. So I'm going to go with the light. Another thing you can do too is that when if you have our BB cream samples and you're testing them out on the skin, when you put the swatch on and you work it into the skin, this basically disappears into Linda's skin. So that would be the one that you want to use. So it's undetectable. This would be too warm for her skin. Sometimes maybe during the summer, maybe she has some more sun, she can mix the two together just to warm up the skin a little bit. I'm taking my foundation buffing brush, going into the fair BB cream. I like to work it into the brush nicely so it'll go on perfectly. So it's not going to be just on one side of the brush or on the other. It's gonna be nicely saturated into the brush. And what I'm gonna do is, I'm going to just buff it into the skin. So you can see that it really gives a beautiful, just even tone look. It's very light, it's not heavy, and it doesn't look like you're wearing a ton of makeup. And that's really what I wanted for you. You wanna just definitely bring it down on the neck. But I feel like the buffing brush is a really a nice way to apply the BB cream instead of using a sponge that just soaks it all up. So Linda doesn't have any color to her face with cheeks and lips, and that makes a very big difference. So we evened out the tone. I'm gonna go in with my Classic Beach face palette. This is three different beautiful creams as a highlighter, a blush, and a bronzer. So I'm very excited to just really bring out a very pretty, soft look using my flat foundation brush. And I'm going to have Linda smile. I'm going to go right on the cheeks and pull it back. So this is a really beautiful just color that's going to give you that vibrancy. You can also use it on your fingers if you want to. Put your fingers into the palette, work it in. Sometimes the warmth of your finger on the skin really just melts into a really beautiful natural look. I'm going to flip the brush around and just use a little bit of the highlighter. This is a beautiful highlighter for mature skin because it's not glittery. It's not a product that's going to fall all over the face and have all these sparkles. It's just going to give you this really beautiful kind of glossy look on your cheekbones. And I'm going to use a little bit of the bronzer. I'm going to, even though Linda's very fair, I'm going to take the bronzer and I'm going to just put it right here at the base of the cheekbone. And then I like work it in. So she can use a little bit of depth. These are very forgiving being a cream. You have a lot of range to work them in, to blend them in. So you don't have to worry like, oh no, it's going to be like some big streak. You can get it as nice and natural as you want, or you can go a little bit more. So you're going to see we have the bronzer just right there. And I work it into the cheek there. So she just gets a little bit of definition. I'm going to add color to the lips now with our waterproof lip liner in Rosé All Day. I'm using my concealer lip brush. So you have actually two in one. You can use this, the larger brush for concealer or for your lip, depending on what you want to do with it. The other side you pull out and you have your lip brush. So this is something that's very easy to use, you can get a very precise if you're using a darker color. This is the way to apply your lipstick. So we're using Pretty Smart and we're going to just apply this to the lips. It's going to be a very beautiful, just soft pink. What you can do, ladies, after you put your lipstick on, if you want to give a little bit more definition, sometimes I like to do this where I'll just take the lip liner again and I'm going to outline the lips just in case I feel like I want it to be a little bit more crisp. So I'll take this Rosé All Day and I'm going to just outline a little bit and then I just work it in if I want to create that signature color. I'm going to take our Nikita Banana. It's a brightening powder. It's a pressed powder. It's triple milled. It's talc-free. I'm just going to roll a new eyeshadow blending brush in here just to touch up underneath the eyes. I want to set that concealer. I'm going to take Coco 13. This is one of my favorite lip glosses, and I know Linda has this. Yeah. So we're going to just top this because you know that I love to give a beautiful, just a high gloss lip. You don't have to put it on the whole lip. You can just put it on the center. So this is a beautiful look for day. Now, if Linda was going from, say, the Botanical Gardens where she's volunteering and she's going out in the city or she's going out for dinner and she wants to do a quick kind of just spruce up but look more evening, you can take your eyeshadow palette. I'm just going to take the darkest color and I'm going to take my, actually, I'm going to take the short smudge brush. It's like my little eraser brush. I'm going to go into this product, into the darkest color. And I'm just going to, this will give her a really nice day to night. So you'll see, I'm just concentrating on this outer corner going up into the crease and then we'll blend it out. But this is going to give you that easy transition. So Linda doesn't have to do her makeup all over again. She has a beautiful lip that's going to be able to transition from day to night. We're just adding a little bit more of this beautiful, just very soft, but a little bit darker color in the crease. You can see how beautiful this looks and gives that more glamorous look, but very little effort. There's not a lot going on here. I'm going to take my blending brush, my eyeshadow blending brush, just softly. I don't want to move that product too much. I still want that intensity. Now, another thing you could do, because I want to give you options so you don't feel that you would have to start over or go home and do your makeup again. Let's take the dark chocolate and go across. So this is the darkest color of the two we did. I'm going to intensify it just a little bit, and I'm going to concentrate on this outer corner here. So really like three quarters. So I'm going right here and I am just pressing down a little bit harder. So I'm not going to blend it or anything. I want that intensity for the eyeliner. So we have the eyeliner, a little bit more of the eyeshadow, and you have a really beautiful look. You can put on the lip gloss again. You can do a little bit harder with your lip liner, the Rosé All Day. You have a lot of options. You can do a little bit more blush also. So this takes it from a day to evening, because I know that Linda's doing a lot. She's very busy. So we have really what I showed you, two different looks. One's going to be more day, intensifying it with just a couple little tricks into evening, which is great. When you're on the move, when you're doing things and you really want to kind of give a little bit of that glam for evening, but not feel like you have to do a ton of things. You can easily do that. And I wanted to show you that with this beautiful look for Linda. So we're going to show her what she looks like, see what she thinks, see how it brings her to life.
Oh, oh boy. Oh,
can you see yourself now?
Yeah. Great job on the eyes and the lip. Oh my. I love it. It's beautiful. I mean, I'm not saying I'm beautiful. I'm saying it's beautiful. I'm beautiful.
You are. Yes. Yes.
Oh, that's so nice. Thank you so much. I just love it.
So working with Linda, this is something that I think we all do. And I think that it's really important, the self-talk, because a couple of things that you said where when you just said, oh, it's beautiful. Well, I'm not beautiful, well, but it's beautiful.
It's
right?
Like braggy to say I'm beautiful.
Well, no, it's not. Yeah. It's about self-love, ladies. Yeah. And I think that if you're not talking to yourself first and saying, you know what, I do look beautiful, or, you know, it doesn't matter what number on the scale, or, you know, I'm doing the best that I can. Those are really important takeaways, because it starts with you first, right? You can't expect everybody else to be saying things to you or building you up. It's from that self-talk first. So it's good to be aware of it, that you are beautiful, right? Whether you had makeup on or not, right? You have so much to offer this world. You're doing so many things. And I think that's what's hard for women to accept, right? Someone gives you a compliment. Oh, no, this. Yeah. Oh, no, right. I don't. It's this has been on podcasts. I've been listening to a lot of this lately where we just can't, we can't accept that, right? We can't accept, you know, I am beautiful. There's nothing wrong saying that. It doesn't mean that you're bragging or what have you. So I want you to have that takeaway that you are beautiful. You tell yourself that in the mirror. No makeup on, doing your skincare, just seeing yourself, what have you, because it starts from that very moment that you say that, because that's the energy you're going to bring into your volunteerism, all of these different things, because you are, you know, and we all are. So ladies, I hope you enjoyed Linda's beautiful makeup tutorial today. And until our next video, we'll see you later. Thank you for being a part of this Fierce Aging series, ladies. If you love this kind of content, celebrating age, seeing women from all over the world, please like, comment below, and subscribe to the channel. We're so excited to see you on the next one.